let go of the real me.
Some believe that bravery is perseverance, strength, and the absence of fear. But one woman, Flora Terra, has brought on a new meaning to this word.
We are gathered here today to pay respect and special attention to those who have dedicated and even given up their lives for peace.
Despite the many obstacles she has encountered, she refuses to let her spirit be killed.
We are honored to introduce Flora as an incredible advocate against political violence and women's rights.
Thank you so much. Wow. Never seen so many, many students. Well, this is my third visit to this school as a guest speaker, but I feel that this is a very special day for me. It's a very special day for me because I have made Canada my second home. Canada is a country of hope. As I sat down there, one of the students asked me, how is it to be in Africa? How is Africa like? Well, I knew he knew about conflicts. I knew he knew about war and strife in Africa. But I did tell him that Africa is a very beautiful continent. And indeed it is. We have to deal with strife. And as I stand before him today, I see so many judges. I see so many advocates. I see very high profile lecturers and name it. And I will tell you that there's so many people that have sacrificed to have this beautiful country. To bring Canada to its dream, to bring Canada to what it is. And these are the people that have sacrificed their lives in war, as we remember them today. And as someone who is born and brought up in Kenya, I will tell you, you are a very privileged society. You're very privileged to be Canadians. Do not take these privileges for granted. And as we remember the soldiers today, I have someone, I sat with a friend of mine in Montreal where I reside, and his name is Adam, and a very, very successful advocate, a lawyer. He's going to Afghanistan next year, and as I sat with him in his early 30s, I did ask him, what takes you there? You're too successful. Why would you want to go to Afghanistan? And probably, there's so many people that have died there. Canadian soldiers, many have died abroad. Why would you want to go? We sat for a long time talking about it. And I could see the passion in him. He wanted to serve. He wanted to make a difference. It was not about him. It was about his country. It was about the commitment and the conviction. And that's what I want us to remember today. Who are we? And what do we stand for? Yes. You are privileged, very privileged, but that is not enough. You need to start engaging yourselves. You need to start asking, who am I? And what am I going to do to make the world a better place? As you have heard from the two young people who have introduced me, I have gone through hell and back. I was once a mother, and I believe I am a mother. My child was murdered, my only child was murdered. But I'm still going back to my country next year because of my conviction, my commitment to see Kenya become Kenya, to drive Kenya to this dream. That is my commitment. Canada being a very beautiful country, I'm still going back after 2 years of being here in exile. I'm still going back to serve my people. And I hope, with all what Canadians are doing to the rest of the world, so many people immigrating to Canada, political immigrants, and other people that are immigrating in search of good pasture, green pasture, I hope that you also engage as young people to know that your parents are working for people like me. The money they pay for the income tax they pay, part of it takes care of the immigrants through the resettlement program. The refugees are taken care of by the government, but your parents are part and parcel of it because it's out of the money that they pay that we are able to restructure our lives in Canada. I truly thank you, and thank you for inviting me to be your guest speaker in such a day, and I feel so honored. And I hope all of you will start thinking how to make the world a better place. And with those few remarks, I thank Canada and I thank all of you, and it's my honor to be part of this memorial. Thank you so much.
Now this next poem is called